My name is Katie Daughter Erpile, and I am co-owner with my husband David here at Cow Comfort Inn Dairy. We are located in Union Bridge, Maryland, which is about 20 minutes south of Gettysburg, right over the Pennsylvania border, and about 45 minutes from Baltimore. Our farm is located in the Little Pipe Creek watershed that then flows into the Monocacy River, that then flows into the Potomac River, and eventually ends up in the Chesapeake Bay. So we're not very far from the bay at all. Let's talk about manure. Manure is the best natural resource you can find on a farm. One, we always have a surplus of it. And two, it's a natural fertilizer. So we take a lot of our manure and we put it out in the fields to help our crops grow in order to be able to feed our cows all year long. When we first moved here, there was just one manure pit that held 1 million gallons of manure. You might think that's a lot, but it's actually not for 400 cows and one facility. So we again worked with our local agencies to help put a plan together and get funding. Funding is really key for farmers, especially first-generation farmers where we don't have a lot of money. And we were able to put in another pit, and this pit is 1.5 million gallons that it holds. And we were also able to put up a structure that holds solid manure. So you might wonder why we need all this storage room for all the manure. Why can't we just put it out in the fields all the time? Well, one, if I have crops growing, you don't want to run them over and having to fertilize that way. The biggest reason we have this is because in the state of Maryland, we cannot spread manure from November until March. We have a really big chunk of time there where we need to be able to hold manure somewhere. And the reason we can't spread manure in the wintertime is if you think about it, the ground freezes. And when the ground freezes, nothing can soak through. So it doesn't make sense to be able to go out and put manure on that ground if the ground is frozen. So during those winter months, we need to have ample storage space to be able to store all of this manure until that ground thaws and we're able to get back out there and fertilize the ground. When we spread manure, we do it many different ways. We can spread it with a manure spreader. We can dragline it, which saves on fuel. And we also have started implementing a new technology, which is injection, which we actually take an implement and it injects the manure into the soil. So it doesn't have a lot of odor. It's better for the soil because it's going into the soil a lot deeper than it would, say, if we were just covering on the top. We also have a nutrient management plan, which is a plan that is put together where we worked with our state and county agencies to put together a plan to say, okay, you have this much manure, but this much acreage. How can you spread it? When can you spread it? And we follow that to a T. So once the cows come to the milking parlor, we go in and we scrape all their stalls, make sure all the manure is out of it, which we have alley scrapers, which we call squeegees, that clean the barn 24/7. So all that manure is getting scraped down so our cows remain clean. But then we can take that manure and we dry it out, which is really cool. It's like a corkscrew, if you kind of think it that way. So it squeezes all the water out. The water then goes into our manure pits, which then goes out on the fields. But what we're left with, if you think about it, manure is really just digested food. So what we're left with is the fiber. And so once you dry that out, it makes a really fluffy, dry, consistent bedding that we are then able to put back in the beds for the cows. So it's a really cool cycle here. We are dairy farmers because we love to take care of our cows, because we love to take care of our land. We have actually found that working with the agencies here in the state have actually been very helpful in being able to fund things, funding our manure projects that we have going on here. Because as a first generation farmer, we don't have the equity that multi-generational family farms have. We don't have a surplus of anything to help us do that. So as first generation farmers, we are super thankful that we're able to work with these agencies in order to be able to put these projects in to help the environment, to make sure that this farm is here for years to come.